thanks for staying with us. So, yesterday, many of us witnessed the inauguration of the United States of America's 46th president, Joe Biden, and his vice president, who is Black American, half Asian, and the first female vice president in the United States. And it was an interesting thing to watch the entire ceremony. Everybody had their face mask on, and the patriotic speeches, the fact that everybody kept referencing what happened two Wednesdays ago on January 6th, saying that the democracy was attacked, and the fact that their fragile democracy could have been totally hit at the root if that January 6th event was allowed to go the way it did. But they are grateful that even with all that, they were able to overcome and still be able to come on the day like as yesterday to inaugurate their new president. But I just wanted to hear your thoughts on not just about the inauguration, but more on this vice president who is female, who is not your perfect family woman. You know how in Nigerian culture, when a woman has to be married with her husband and have her husband's name, have her children, you know, the whole Nigerian story. But this is a woman who is married to a man and she decides to keep her own name, you know, and she's having her stepchildren as her kids. And, you know, she's running her family the way she knows her, and yet she's been able to accomplish herself to this level. So what are your general thoughts? What came to mind when you're seeing the Kamala up there on stage? I'd like to hear your views.
For me, when I was seeing Kamala yesterday, I was watching it yesterday, and because America is the country that everybody looks up to, it was a good thing that a woman had become president there.
Vice president.
Well, if anything happens to you,
she becomes the president.
She's president. Mm-hmm. You know? So that is the real essence of, because Joe Biden is 77.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. So it's, for me, it was a good thing, but I had to reverse and ask myself, as a Nigerian, is it possible in this Nigeria of today for a woman to become president? Because in my belief, I believe that if a woman becomes president in Nigeria, the correct woman becomes president in Nigeria, Nigeria will change. Mm. Nigeria will be the country we all want to be in, because women are nurturers. And being a nurturer, you will be able to nurture your country back into... That's my belief, you know? So
we saw the example with Liberia. Liberia was able to have that first president, and we all celebrated it at the time. But we thought that would inspire us.
And she did well.
We thought that would inspire Africa at least to begin to encourage more women into political office. So, yes, we were all happy about the inauguration yesterday. We saw Kamala. When she was taking her oath. You know, I was practically taking her oath with her. Mm-hmm. But the point is that, do we have that kind of leadership? Do we have women who we can begin to push to get to that height in politics? Are there people who have demonstrated their capability in such a way that we feel that as a people, this person can lead this country? I mean, 2023 is still far away. Thank you, Wiking, for taking us there, because maybe we should just park the American story on one side and focus on how we can focus on getting a female president. Because nobody is talking about female president in Nigeria. They're only talking about APC, PDP, Igbo, South, North. Mm-hmm. That's all we're hearing.
Yeah.
Nobody's saying maybe it's time for us to have a female president.
We have enough. We actually have enough women. Like, we have enough women who've displayed competence, who can lead this country well. We actually do. We have from the North, we have from the South, we have from the East, we have from the West. We have from the middle belt. So I know that it's not about the person or capacity of the people. It is more about the way our political wiring has been done to create a disadvantage against women. Because we have a system that, the way it is right now, the cost of running your political election in Nigeria is ridiculously expensive. From campaign to funding every unit, no individual has successfully can make a decision. They would need a rallying force of many people. Mm-hmm. Do we have enough Nigerian men who would be willing to back a Nigerian woman to become the president? Because it would take a bipartisan of both male and female to support one person as a female to become the president. I don't think we have that political will yet. I don't think we have that. We are ready at that point. I think that the first goal should be, let's even have a female vice president. And then we have if an active vice president as a female vice president. If we can get to that point, let's have a female president of the Senate. Let's have a female speaker. We had a female speaker.
Yeah.
They roped her into something, and then something something happened. But let's have such female strong figures.
Yeah. Okay. I know Obiajulu wants to talk,
okay,
but I just want to say something quickly because I want to go back to Murayo. Murayo, we just finished a discussion on Bride Price. And we're not talking of
female
presidents. are we conflicting in our emotions?
How, please?
Because we are saying we want, Bride Price, we should remain as, you must.
Culture.
And now we're saying female president. Is it the woman that they paid for that will now become president?
That even takes me to my point. So I wanted to say that I don't think we should rush things. We're not there yet. That's the truth. Our culture is heavily patriarchal, where even in, we're still struggling with inequality between the sexes. We still have that in many organizations today. You don't get the kind of support when it comes to a woman taking certain positions, not because they are not competent, but because you feel they are under somebody. Will she be able to do the midnight meetings? Will her husband let her?
She do changes. She doesn't have the midnight anymore.
It can't work during the day. That's the structure that's working, because most executives, most meetings where you need to, in fact, let me not even go far. Our entrepreneurs and very big business, the Dangotes, they meet in the midnight. That is where they have time to discuss and have serious, interventions in their jobs and everything. So this is how our politics is run. Will she be allowed, peradventure this person is married, will she be allowed to come out in the midnight today, tomorrow? They will start, the way the rumors go. Probably she's not sleeping with this politician, all of that. So we are not there yet. I don't think we should rush it. Now, for America, they've come to that level where they put competence above the sexes, whether you are a male or female. Once they see you can deliver, you are there for the job. We are still struggling with that.
Let me go on a break. When we come back, we'll continue on this. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Stay tuned. Your View will be right back.
Thanks for staying with us. So we are still on the issue of who do we think, especially a female leading this country? I'd like to hear some names, though. I mean, I know it's hard for us to mention it, but there are people who have demonstrated
leadership,
some sense of responsibility. I mean, people know I already love Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala, but people have asked her several times to see if she can run. And she said, Nigeria, I mean, I read her book and she's she's no thank you. I mean, I've seen a few interviews of her where they asked her directly and she's like, nah, she'll just stay on the international level because they value her more and they appreciate the work she's doing and giving to their society. But in our view, do we have this kind of women that we can all begin to discuss and say, you know what, let's push this person?
I like it, Bukwa Woshika. I like Adiza Usman,
the NPA boss.
Yes, the NPA boss. Bukwa Woshika has displayed leadership consistently across board. Ngozi is not going to want to come to work here, but I like Obi Ezekwesili. Like, you love to hate her. You don't like her controversy. I love Obi Ezekwesili.
Okay.
She's not perfect. But I think that I've read a few tweets and they're saying, don't focus on sex, let's focus on competence. And I said, and my own is, we've tried men for 60 years in Nigeria. We've tried men. So if we've tried men, why don't we try women? According to the Nigerian Bureau of Statistics, we have more women than men in the country anyway. So we might as well give them opportunity to lead. And let's see. Let's even compare with the worst leadership we've had.
What's that famous quote you, coach, what they call it? These life coaches like to use. You can't continue doing the same thing and expect
different results.
So let's
try a woman. Don't bring a case of we've had bad women. We've had men 60 years.
Bad men too.
I haven't read the tweets. But this one that you're saying, they're saying, let's not focus on sex, let's focus on competence. That's what I'm saying. Let us focus on competence. And if it's a woman that is competent, let her do it. Let us not, but I agree with Obiajulu when she says, we're not there, because even a security guard, if you fight him, say, I have your type at home.
Bam. You put here.
Who is your type that you have at home?
I'm not your type. I'm
not. Do you understand? You know?
So, okay, no, right, I'll tell you.
Yes, now. Nah. Exactly.
Have you watched the interview that Muhammadu did? The CNN interview. When you watched that interview, I could understand. Because she said, as a woman, to do the kind of things I'm doing, you need to be tough.
And they call you aggressive.
You need to be hard, and they will call you aggressive. Mm. Then you need to be tough, you need to be hard. Mm. And people say that about her. Mm. And I think that she's also someone that I would vote for.
Okay. Mm. Let me add to that. For me, I think we should move beyond people who are in politics when we want to look for leadership. Mm. We should look at people who have been able to create something from nothing. Everybody's complaining the harsh situation in the country, the harsh this,
the
harsh.
There
solutions. Are people who are building enterprises, who are creating businesses, who are empowering people in the private sector. Such persons, when you put them in a place, they will be able to create this one that most of our leaders do not are bereft of ideas to even generate income in their state. People who can create something out of nothing, give them in that, put them in that position, and they will create something for the country. So I'm not even looking at people who are in politics. I'm looking at who are popular. I'm looking at people who are creators. That's what we need. We need an economic change in the country. So let us look at individuals. You know, why I wanted to say this, you know, we had the, what's it called, the sentiment of integrity, this one, that one. I mean, I was sitting, I was asking myself, what in the years that this particular person has not been in government, what has he done for his people? What has he created for his people? Is it the best that we can muster? So it's not about whether you can fight corruption or you have integrity. That's what we're looking at. We're looking at what can you do with the gold mine that is Nigeria giving into your hands.
I hear you. But
then, secondly, I also wanted to mention that, you know, this patriarchy we talk about, it's even the women that uphold it. It's the women that at the end of the day, they will not support you for whatever reason. The men, when they see that you have competence, they will want to push you forward. But it's the women around you that will now feel, why her? Why should we push her forward? So we need to still look at that if we want a woman to lead
us. There is this man that
has
just tweeted, HJ. He says, at the iniquity, I disagree that a female president will solve all Nigeria's problems. Mm. Look, Have we forgotten Diziani, Sirleaf Johnson, had serious issues with nepotism in Liberia? The fact is we should get a competent leader, whether male or female, both sexes in Nigeria are corrupt.
Mm.
I agree. I totally agree that both sexes are corrupt. They are all human.
Yes.
We are all human.
Everybody has that.
Female leader who they try to bribe. That thing in
which country?
This country now, that the minister, they all went to the Senate. Oh, I've forgotten her name.
No. Try to bribe.
She's with NDM, NDDC. They had issues. She was the head of NDDC.
That she slapped somebody.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
She had issues with the commissioner.
Yes.
The commissioner in charge of Niger Delta.
Is it YK? Let me tell you why I don't really agree with you with the Twitter. You see, sometimes we should just say it exactly as it is.
Mm.
Let's try a woman, period.
Let's just try because we've been doing this thing over and over again.
Mm. I hear you, competence is important, absolutely.
Let's bring
a woman who is competent, but let's bring a woman.
Mm.
Because we believe that she feels that for a woman, there's a higher stake.
Yeah.
It's not just, I'm just the president. There's more at stake for her. And she'll have that drive to ensure that she leaves a legacy that people can say, yes, this person was the first female president, and she came, she saw, and she was able to develop Nigeria and take Nigeria away from that pit that she found Nigeria. So I hear the sentiment of let us not focus on that, but I'm also being sentimental. Let us bring a woman. Let's find a woman who is competent and push her for 2023. Let the various parties front a woman. But there are women who have actually shown capacity in different ways. There's this woman, this bank, something David Boras, I can't remember her first name. Yeah, I think she's the chairman or the ED of one of the baby banks.
These are people
who have shown economic strength.
Yes, that's what we need. They're
educated,
so
they're smart.
So there's a track record. Because at the end of the day, we have career politicians.
Yeah.
And for every time you are elected, and America just elected a career politician. Joe Biden has been in politics for the past 50 years. Mm. However, there's a track record of policies. There's a track record of action, consistency of service. We have tried politicians who've been playing the politics game. We could say that let's deviate from this political theme. Mm. And citing examples of some states that have gone with technocrats and the success they've achieved. Mm. So if we now say let's try technocrats and try a female technocrat as opposed to a female politician, we might see better results. However, we have a corrupt system that involves everybody. Because the female person will need to still pay using Indomie to get votes. She will still use. She will still need to give rice, give sugar, do campaign, sell. You know, all those things. We need. Those are the things we really, really need to deal with, so that people are not voting based on.
You know what I think? For every female politician that is corrupt, there are 50.
Yes, now
corrupt male.
Yeah.
Because they are in the majority.
Mm. Well,
if the female are in the majority too, it may not be that different.
Yeah, now, but you see, I think we should not sell ourselves short as women.
Exactly.
Mm. We shouldn't sell. We should try. Look, push ourselves. I totally agree with Morayo. I know, and I understand where you're coming from. We are not there yet because of those that I have your type at home.
Yeah.
Vote for who? Mm. You know, we have them, but a woman can lead. Mm. Let's not ever.
Okay, I have somebody in mind that I want to say.
Okay, call her name.
And not because I think she's competent, but I think she has the posture for the kind of leadership Nigeria needs.
Posture.
That kind of person who she. This woman I'm about to mention. Oh, if I mention that, I'll get in trouble.
Tell us first.
If I mention this person might not have. This person might not have the competence, but if we surround her with people that can strengthen her, but I think she has the personality, that the kind of Nigeria that we have seen.
Mm-hmm.
Nigeria is not the kind of person you can take English and talk to them. No.
You need a choleric.
Who submits scatter ground?
You need a choleric.
You need somebody who is ready to. And who do I think? Patience Jonathan. You see, that kind of person needs competent people around her.
I agree with you.
That woman decisive.
I agree with you.
She enters a room, you know she don't enter.
Yes, so.
Yeah.
She will not take nonsense.
Yes.
She will be on everybody's parasitic.
Yes, so.
I am watching.
She will follow up.
She will follow up. These are the kind of personalities we need in Nigeria.
I don't disagree with you.
I agree.
Honestly, because at the end of the day,
people are going to trend. For everyone.
No, we love her.
No, but Pepe made a point.
Oh, God. Patience was known to be very vocal.
Yes.
She speaks her mind. And it's one of the issues we have currently in Nigeria, which is that we don't see our leaders.
Mm.
And then we don't hear from our leaders.
Yes.
And they don't have a posture of, I will not take nonsense.
Yes,
one of the problems we have in this country is not lack of policy. We have many good fantastic policies.
Absolutely.
The issue is implementation, lack of
follow through.
Somebody that will damn all consequences and say, I want this building done. Anybody that is taking the money, give me their name, I will deal with them, they will go to jail. That is the kind of thing we need to see.
And she has it. So the thing now is to surround her with people who will come up with
all her ministers,
creative ideas.
All her future advisors, they'll all be, these ones that are really smart, intelligent people.
Yes.
And
trust me, she can handle this now.
Should we
push her forward?
We are pushing Pepe to become
our president. Another person that can speak up, really. And another person that can speak up.
They are saying that she was corrupt now.
Do we think that I think that a corrupt person, in terms of leadership of this country, we have tried the non-corrupt person, and the system hasn't our president went on the campaign and said that he's not corrupt. So, as a person, I won't even believe that our president personally isn't a corrupt person.
Yeah. Mm.
So, but how has the system worked?
Mm.
So, they say Yoruba says ole no mo se ole to. That means. A thief knows how to trace a thief.
Uh-huh.
A corrupt person doesn't have to trace a corrupt person.
Uh-huh.
We might not be looking for a saint.
Yeah.
Let's find like a good thief that knows all the crooks and the crooked ways and the loopholes and can deal with it. Which is what the president said yesterday about Donald Trump. The guest said that, like it or not, Donald Trump had this attitude of, I will say anything, I will press the button, I will blow you up anywhere you are.
Yes.
And sort of everybody started feeling like we were on shaky ground.
Told us now.
And it made things work to a large extent. The economy a bit improved. People started sitting up on, of course, it's erratic.
Iran was silent. They said the ISIS
was silent. North Korea was
silent
because they felt this man, we don't know where he is.
He is not the one that made the economy improve.
Yeah.
The economy was already improving. It was Obama that set the pace for him. But now, as of today, the economy is down. So what I hear what Mariah is saying, we need a strong, I don't care person.
Mm-hmm. Personality.
I understand that. I hear her, I believe in it. A person who will just stand, man or woman.
Take a stand. A minute.
Not be doing nepotistic
appointments.
Then if you cannot, if we know Nigerians, we have a problem of, hey, you cannot speak Soprin, we don't need it. You can speak your local dialect and get an interpreter.
Yes.
We want somebody to get the job done. That's what we
Simple.
Want. Let's push
it. You don't need to speak English now.
That's what I'm saying. But you know Nigerians, now if you don't,
you don't speak English.
At this table, because nobody speaks swear.
You would have beaten us.
Maybe Mary and me bitch. I mean, has some in her mouth. The rest of us.
But Nigerians in the hall.
What I think that we should campaign for
women. She wants to do an American now.
You
do sometimes. You don't know.
American people, when they come on set, and you say,
no,
that's
not true.
Excuse me.
That's not true.
Of course, I will look for the videos.
Can we not lose the value of what we came up with, which is that a woman can lead this country. A woman can lead this country well. We've tried men for 60 years. I think 2023 we should start looking towards women, and women that feel competent should speak up and let those that have the money rally around a woman. We will be here on this show. We will support
you. Get four votes at least. Okay, Reju, four votes.
And all our hundreds of thousands of followers.
We have to
go. I have to go and beg Bolo.
We'll see you tomorrow. Bye for now. At least you have.